Okay, we have two functions on the spot. The first one is f of x is equal to just one square root with x plus 1 times x plus 2 inside. And for the second one, we have two square roots. The first one is with x plus 1 inside, and the second one is with x plus 2 inside. And the question is, are they the same function? What do you guys think? Well, you know, you have to be really careful with these kind of questions that look like, oh, yeah, of course, right? It's definitely true, but no. Pay attention to the technical details, and usually we have to pay attention to the domain, especially when you have like, are these two functions the same question? All right, so let's go ahead and just observe the domain of f first. So let's see for the domain of f. Well, we have one square root. That means we'll just have to put the inside to be greater than or equal to zero. That's the criteria when we are dealing with the square root of the inside, right? So we just have to pay attention to x plus 1 times x plus 2. These two things multiplying, and then make sure that we do end up with positive or zero. All right, so this is actually pretty nice because we can see the numbers that we care, or some books will call this the cut numbers, or just the zero of this pretty much. But here's one thing that you don't want to do. When you have two factors multiplying and then you have an inequality, do not just say x plus 1 is greater than or equal to 0 and then x plus 2 is greater than or equal to 0. No, cannot do that here. Cannot do that here. No. Pay attention to here because we only have one inequality and this is a nonlinear inequality. Do it the safe way. Let's look for the numbers that we care. Again, some books call this the cut points, the cut numbers. You put the first number, think about how can you make it equal to zero. X has to be negative 1. So we care about negative 1. And then from the second number here, we care about negative 2. So we care about these two numbers. Then what we do next is you draw a number line. Negative 2 is right here to the left. And then here we have negative 1. And you go ahead, pick a number less than negative 2. Let's say negative 3. What we do is we put negative t3 into here and here and see if it's a true statement or not. Well, do the sign chart pretty much. Here, negative 3 here, we get negative 2 times negative 1. So it's negative times negative, which is going to give us a positive. And if you pick a number between negative 1 and negative 2, let's say negative 1.5. Put it here, we get negative. Put it here, we get positive. Negative times positive, we get negative. Then we pick a number bigger than negative 1, let's say 0. Put it here, we get positive. Put it here, we get positive. Altogether, we get positive. So now, look at this sign chart and then just determine the interval that we need. For the domain, we care about the positive or zero, so we care about these two numbers as well because it has the equal sign. So we care about this piece. That means we go from negative infinity up to negative 2, including the negative 2. We don't want the middle piece. We do want this piece. So union, and we go from negative 1, and we go to infinity. So this right here is the domain of f. Now, for the second one, be really careful with it. We have two square roots. First, we have to worry about this right here being greater than or equal to zero. So again, this is the domain for g. First condition, we want to have x plus 1 is greater than or equal to zero. In the meantime, we also have this x plus 2 inside of another square root. The keyword is another square root. So we also have to make sure that this thing, x plus 2, is also greater than or equal to 0. So earlier, we are solving just one inequality. Right now, we are dealing with two inequalities, and we have to look for the intersection. For this one, we can just put the negative 1 to the other side and say x is greater than or equal to negative 1. For this one, we can just put a 2 to the other side and say x is greater than or equal to negative 2. All right, for this, we can just say Here is negative, that's a little bit too far. All right, for this, let's say this right here is negative 1, and we want it to be greater than or equal to, so we go to the right like this. And then for this, well, let's line up, and let's say negative 2 is right here, and we include that as well. And we want to go to the right, so it's like this. Now, I want this and that both to happen at the same time. So we're looking at the intersection, the overlapping part, which is anything from negative 1 or to the right. So in fact, the domain for g of x is negative 1, including negative 1, and then we go to infinity. So this is the domain for f, and this is the domain for g. You see? For f, we have this extra part, but for g, right here, it does not, just because how the expression is written in the first place. So, let's go ahead and answer this question. Are they the same function? No. Technically, no. Why? Because they have what? Different domains. Right, so pay close attention to the domains. That's usually the technical details. That's it.